This video explains how to use Raptor to solve a problem using a loop. Here's the problem. Generate a table that displays a list of numbers and the square of those numbers. Ask the user how many numbers to include in the list. Display the sum of all the squares we compute. The output should look like this. First, we ask how many numbers should be in the table. The user enters 6 in this case. We print a table with a header, number and square, and equal signs to make a line underneath. Then we print a table with the number and the square. The square of 1 is 1, the square of 2 is 4, and so on. Finally, we print a message saying what the sum of the squares are. In this case, 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16 plus 25 plus 36. Now, keep this problem handy and we'll start using Raptor. Start at the beginning. We need to ask how many numbers should be in the table. That's an input symbol. The prompt is how many numbers should be in the table. Make sure we put quotes around that. The variable is entries. Now we need to display the table header. That takes two output symbols. For the first one, the output is just number, then some space, and then square in quotes. The second one is just a bunch of equal signs in quotes. We want to keep the end current line checked. After the header, we need to display a number and its square repeatedly. That means we need a loop. Click on loop and put it in the flowchart. Every loop needs an exit condition, which means when do we stop? In this case, we stop when number is bigger than the number of entries we asked for. Double-click the loop and enter number greater than entries. We already have a variable for entries from our input symbol, but we need a variable for number. We'll call it number. What should we set number to begin with? Initialize number to 1 before we start the loop. Set square equal to number times number below the diamond. Now we have values for our number and for the square. We can output them. To do that, output number, then some space, then square. Use plus to combine them on one line. Number plus spaces plus square. The last thing we always have to do in every loop is modify the loop variable. In this case, our loop variable is number. Look at the assignment. How does the number change each time? It goes up by 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we will add 1 to number. Number is assigned number plus 1. Now let's see what happens when we run it. Click on play. We're asked how many variables should be in the table. We'll enter 6. And we see that we have a table showing our numbers and the squares. Now, let's run it again using 20. Notice we can use the slide up here to change the speed. And here we see all of our numbers and their squares in a table. Our program is not done yet. We still need to compute the sum of our squares. We need another variable. We'll call it sum. Before we have any squares, the value of sum is 0, so we'll initialize it before the loop. Sum is set to 0. Now, every time we compute a new square, we will add to that sum. Sum equals sum plus square. Finally, we need to display our sum. Add an output symbol after the loop. Now, run the program. Does it do what we expect? Yes, we see our table, and the sum of these squares is 91. This is the end of the video on loops in Raptor.